Hi, I'm Andy Burrows here for Tides TV. I'm here with Rachel Law, the Enablement Manager at GSK. Thank you for joining us today.
No problem.
So in the last year, you've launched the European Pharmaceutical Oligonucleotide Consortium. Could you just tell me a little bit about that?
Yeah, absolutely. So EPOC, as we call it, because it's a bit easier, is a group of seven pharma companies. So it's made up of GSK, Pfizer, AstraZeneca, Roche, Janssen, Sanofi, and Biogen. We have come together to try and promote the publication of information about oligonucleotides and really trying to gather all of the knowledge that we have together and put forward some industry perspective on how we might be able to develop these therapeutics in slightly different ways. It really came about from some presentations I gave last year, so the first of which was at Eurotides and the second of which was at the EMA at a workshop about prior knowledge. Mm-hmm. After the talks, people from the various companies came up to me and said, actually those ideas that you had or the concept of collaborating is something we'd be really interested in. How about we kind of start doing something? So it was really good because it's organically grown. There's no individual company that feels like they're being dragged along, and it's very much everybody wants to be a part of it. And really the idea is to publish, to get information in the public domain and be able to get that information more widely available.
And so collaboration, I guess, is the key word here. Where do you see collaboration as being particularly important?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the thing with the oligonucleotides, the very few products that are actually approved out there, and with approved products comes public information. So there's an awful lot of data and information, there's a lot of expertise, but it's all in little silos between right. different companies. And really that's where pre-competitive collaboration and publication comes into its own, because by gathering that information together, by publishing it, we can make it available not just to people within the consortium, but also to the whole oligonucleotide community, and hopefully be able to push some of the therapeutics forwards. And ultimately, the goal is obviously to get medicines available to patients, and these medicines are typically complex and for rare diseases. So if there's anything that we can do to drive that and make it more simple, then that's the aim. So really that collaboration of gathering and compiling that data is what's important here.
Right, and looking to the future, the industry is obviously constantly evolving. How do you see collaboration evolving in the coming years?
Yeah, so I mean, EPOC was really, as I say, set up because there isn't that information out there, and, yeah. and as more products get approved, as more information becomes available, the possibility of maybe some ICH guidelines, that would be lovely. But if those kind of things start coming, it might be that EPOC becomes less relevant, and there isn't really a place for us as much. I mean, we're not going to dig our heels in and stick around forever just because we can, although we do have a nice logo now. But we'll stay around as long as we're relevant, and then if we become less relevant, we'll regroup. I mean, we've only been together now formally for about 6 months by the time all the CDAs got signed off and things. So we're certainly very new and we're still evolving, and over the next few years we see ourselves learning and how we're working, evolving, possibility of expanding, and then we'll see where the road takes us really.
Right. Well, good luck with everything.
Thank you very much.
Thanks very much for joining us.
Thanks, no problem.